So today I'm chatting with Inge Schmitz, the CEO of our cable and wireless business across the Caribbean and in Latin America. Welcome, Inge. So I have a quick fact for you. So since cable and wireless has been in business for like more than 50 years or so, you are the first female CEO.
Is that true?
Yeah, it's absolutely true. So congratulations first. But I mean, how do you feel about that?
I never thought about it. Well, I think, you know, like I always say, more has to do with the passion. And if the passion brings you there, it's a great achievement. The thing is, I never look at myself as a CEO. I look at myself as somebody who tries to bring a business and even more so a culture and people forward. So that makes me happy. Yeah. Not so much whether I'm the first female CEO.
Yeah. Well, definitely symbolic, I think, for us in our organization. But what are some of the things that you think contributed to you being here where others might have fallen short in the past?
The first reason why I think I was able to get here was a little bit of luck of good leaders. Back in my Tilner days, back in my Procter & Gamble days, but also now again with Ballon, who dared to take a decision or a risk of allowing me to take the jump, you know.
Yeah.
And if you're not surrounded by people who allow you to take that jump, you'll never get there. So that's the number one. You know, I've been lucky that I've had people allowing me to take jumps. And then I think the if ever I got to where I got, I don't think it's because I'm like smart or extremely. I think it's because of the passion and because of the fact that I'm being able to bring people together behind an objective and go to it together.
So I know, like me, you're a champion of diversity in the business. Why is this important to you?
Because it just, you know, people look at things in a different way, and that's why for me, what I also don't like is when you go completely overboard into one or the other direction. The diversity sits in cultures, the diversity sits in male-female, and you just get to a by far better debate.
Since arriving here, what, 12 months or so ago, you've created a whole new diverse leadership team already. And what value are you seeing from that?
I think we're starting to see it in the business results, and we are starting for sure to see it in the culture, where we build on each other and we help each other to understand the region, Latin region, Caribbean region, which is already different.
So in March, we celebrated International Women's Day, Balance for Better. Having moved to Miami with your family, three incredible children, how do you achieve balance in your life?
Oh. I think 2018, that was probably one of my toughest years in the balance of life. But it's also been the most rewarding. So it was the biggest in terms of roller coaster of ups and downs. But if you, you know, getting to the end of 2018, looking at your family, looking at what you were able to achieve from a business perspective and from a culture perspective, I think it was an interesting year. What I learned from it is that if you put yourself out of your comfort zone, that's one thing, because you can take a decision, okay, I take the job and I do something. But if you do that in combination with a move, and in combination of putting your entire family out of the comfort zone, that's an interesting experience. But it is also a very rewarding experience because you see each one of the, you see each individual growing, and then once it comes together, you see an entire family growing, and that's has been fantastic for us.
And do you have any advice or any tips for others who, you know, are trying to achieve that sort of balance? Anything you've learned, any tips that you could give?
Two tips. One is, I think we as female leaders for a moment, we feel too often too guilty. Whether that is against our husband, whether that's against the kids, whether that is against the business. The second tip I would give is that, you know, be daring to open up on topics. Have an open debate on many of these things.
Yeah.
No matter, you know, people sometimes think because you're sitting at the, as a CEO, you know, you have all the answers, and you have, let's say, you don't dare to ask. You also have to ask still these things, but it's okay.
Yeah. I mean, uniquely, I mean, lots of people in the office know your kids. I know you bring them into work and things like that.
Have you heard the story of my middle daughter who took the position, she wants to become a CEO one day. She thinks she can do that in 2 hours. And then she put it herself into my office, and then she called each one of the people in, and she gave everybody a raise.
Nice.
And then I told her in the evening, I said, you can't do that because people really think, oh, mom, I didn't put anything on paper.
Good. Inge, thank you so much.
Well, thank you.
We have an incredibly diverse organization. Each and every one of us, unique in our own way, makes Liberty Latin America the amazing company that it is.